Okay, in this video lecture, we are going to discuss the various assumptions made by the consumer preferences. The first assumption is completeness. Suppose we have two bundles X and Y. These are the two bundles, bundle X and bundle Y. So they belong to the consumption set, right? And the assumption about X and Y for now is either the consumer would prefer X to Y, or he would prefer Y to X, right? Or he will be indifferent between the two. So it means that he has no other option, right? So he would establish, he would go for this option, or he would go for this option, or he will take both these options simultaneously, which means that he would equally prefer both the bundles. But note that these are weak assumptions, because you can see the preferences of X is greater than or equal to Y. So it means that X is at least as much preferred as Y, and this means that Y is at least as much preferred as X. So it means that you can see the equality. So this is weak. These are weak preferences. This preferences and this preferences are weak, and that's why there is the possibility for the consumer to choose both options. The reason is the equality holds here, right? Had these preferences been something like this, X is strictly preferred to Y, or Y is strictly preferred to X, then this would be impossible to choose both. The reason is there is no equality holds here. So this is the completeness assumption for the preferences. X and Y are two bundles, they belong to the consumption set. So he would either choose this option or both. The existence of both is because of the equality signs here. Okay, the second assumption is reflectiveness, and by reflectiveness we mean that for all X, when we're talking about the for all X, it means that X is not a single bundle. So this X can be something like X1, X2, X3, up to so on. So these are many X's bundles, right? And they belong to the consumption set. X is at least as preferable as X. It doesn't mean that they are same bundles, right? If this is X1, it means that X1 is at least as preferable as X2. Or if this is X2, then X2 is at least as much preferable as X3. So it means that all those bundles which belong to the consumption sets are at least as preferable as other bundles in the same consumption sets. And note that again, these are weak preferences, because you can see the equality signs here. So this is reflectiveness. Well, the third assumption is transitivity. And transitivity is simple, and it doesn't need more explanation. Transitivity, we mean that if there are three consumption bundles, that is a bundle X, bundle Y and bundle C, and suppose all of them belongs to the consumption set, right? So by transitivity we mean that if X is at least as preferable as Y and Y is at least as preferable as Z, then by default X would at least be as preferable as Z. It is something like if A is greater than B and B is greater than C, then A would be definitely greater than C. So this is something like, but this is a rough explanation, because you can see inequality and equality simultaneously. So you can write, you can report the same thing as if A is at least as much B and B is at least as much as C, then A would automatically be at least as much as C. So this assumption is nothing else, this is the transitivity. Note that these are the consumption bundles and each bundle contain the same commodities but different amount of each good. Okay, now it is turn to discuss the continuity assumption. Okay, what do I mean by for continuity assumption? Suppose Y is an X. So it does not mean that Y is a single bundle, it is a series of bundles, right? So it can be Y1 bundle, it can be Y2 bundle, it can be Y3 bundle, right, and so forth. So it is a series of bundles and it belongs to the consumption set. Also note that X also belongs to the consumption set. Again, X will not be a single bundle, X will be X1, X2 up to a series of X bundles. So all Y bundles belong to the consumption set, and the same all X bundles belong to the consumption set. So this is one point. The second point is, look at this set. X is a consumption bundle such that X is at least as preferable as Y. It has two components. It has two components. All those bundles of X which are as much prepared as Y. This is one component, right? All those bundles of X which are as much prepared as Y. The second component, all those bundles which are strictly prepared to Y. So it contains both. The preferences for X can be equal to the preferences for Y. This is one component, and the preferences for X will be greater than for the preferences of Y. So it shows boundary condition, equality and equality with respect to preferences, and inequality in the sense X is preferred to Y. All right, so this is a closet because it contains the boundary bundles as well. By boundary bundles we mean the equality signs holds here. Equal to, when we talk about equal to, it shows all those bundles which lies on boundary of the consumption set, right? And in the same way, if X is such that X is at most as preferable as Y, what does this mean? It means that again it has two components. The preferences for X can be equal to the preferences for Y, or the preferences for X can be less than for the preferences of Y. Again, it contains a boundary points where the preferences for X and Y are same. And it has an open set as well, because when we talk about the preferences for Y is greater than the preferences for X. So these are all those bundles which are not on the boundary. So again, there can be infinite bundles in the consumption set where X and Y will have the same preferences, but there will also be some infinite bundles of X and Y where either X would be strictly preferred to Y or Y would be strictly preferred to X. So both these are closed. The reason is both these contains the equality. The preferences are equal and the preferences are unequal. And look at this set. These are the subset of these sets. Right? Because it has an inequality, but it doesn't have an equality over here. So these sets are the subsets of these sets. These sets, set this set and this set, these are the subset of these sets, because it contains equality and inequality, and it contains inequality here. So it means that there is continuity in the consumption bundle, in the sense that there can be infinite consumption bundles. Some of them will be equal to with respect to preferences, and some of them will be strictly preferred over the other. So if there are infinite consumption bundles, some of them are equal with respect to preferences to each other, but some of them will be strictly preferred to other. If this assumption holds, that it means that continuity holds. And for the analysis of the consumer behavior, we assume that continuity holds in the consumer preferences.